Hello friends, in the learning of capability analysis, we had seen normal capability analysis for multiple variables with practical example in the last video. This video is about fifth part of capability, that is non-normal capability analysis for multiple variables. We are going to learn this part of capability analysis with practical example for easy understanding and better clarity. So let's begin. Non-normal capability analysis for multiple variables. Use non-normal capability analysis for multiple variables to compare the capability of multiple process variable or multiple groups within one process variable based on a non-normal distribution. Using this analysis, you can determine whether the process is capable of producing output that meets customer requirements and compare the overall capability of the process with its between and within capability to assess opportunity for improvements. To perform this analysis, you must specify a lower or upper specification limits or both to define your process requirements. You must also select a non-normal distribution to fit your data. This analysis evaluates the spread of the process data in relation to specification limits. When a process is capable, the process spread is smaller relative to specification spread. This analysis can also indicate whether your process is on target. In addition, it estimates the proportion of product that does not meet specifications. Data considerations for non-normal capability analysis for multiple variables. To ensure that your results are valid, consider the following guidelines when you collect the data, perform the analysis, and interpret your results. These considerations are same as that of non-normal capability analysis for single variable, but it's better to see all of them again. 1. The data should be continuous. Continuous data are measurements that may potentially take on any numerical value within a range of values along a continuous scale, including fractional or decimal values. Common examples include measurements such as length, weight, and temperature. If you have attribute data such as count of defectives or defects, use binomial capability analysis or Poisson capability analysis. We will see these types of analysis in future videos. 2. The data should follow a non-normal distribution. If the selected distribution does not closely fit the data, the capability estimates will not be accurate. To determine which non-normal distribution best fits your data, use individual distribution identification. 3. The process must be stable and in control. If the current process is not stable, then the capability indices cannot be reliably used to assess the future and ongoing capability of the process. If you are not sure whether your process is in control, use X-bar H chart to evaluate the process stability before you perform this analysis. 4. Collect enough data to obtain reliable estimate of process capability. Try to collect at least 100 total data points, that is subgroup size into number of subgroups, such as 25 subgroups of size 4 or 35 subgroups of size 3. If you do not collect a sufficient amount of data over a long enough period of time, the data may not accurately represent different sources of process variation, and the estimate may not indicate the true capability of your process. Example of non-normal capability analysis for multiple variables. A manufacturer uses two machines to package a frozen food. The process is in control and the quality engineer wants to assess whether the amount packaged is affected by the use of two machines. The specifications for the weight of the frozen food packages are 27 gram to 35 gram. The engineer randomly samples 50 packages from each machine and records the weight of each package. The engineer knows that the weight of the food packages follows a largest extreme value distribution. By conducting individual distribution identification having a p-value more than 0.25, and almost all the points fall within the competence bounds of the largest extreme value plot. The engineer then performs non-normal capability analysis for multiple variables to evaluate how well the weight of the food packages meets customer requirements for the two machines. To perform non-normal capability analysis for multiple variables, please follow these steps. 1. select stat, quality tools, capability analysis, and then multiple variables non-normal. 2. In variables, enter weight. 3. Select by variables and enter machine. 4. From fit distribution, select largest extreme value. 5. In lower specifications, enter 27. 6. In upper specifications, enter 35. And 7. Click OK to get the results. You will get the results of study in graph window. Interpretation of results. The PPK is 0.66 for machine 1 and 0.74 for machine 2. Therefore, the overall capability of the machine 2 is slightly better than that of the machine 1. However, the capability indices for both the machines are below 1.33, which is generally accepted minimum value for a capable process. Process performance increases when the process spread is reduced and the process median lies close to the specification's midpoint. For both the machines, the process median is off the specification's midpoint and the process spread is too large relative to specification limits. The manufacturer needs to improve the process. This is all about non-normal process capability for multiple variables. We will see capability analysis for attribute data with practical examples in the next video. For references, I have taken some part of this very detailed content from Minitab. Apart from this video, on your request, we have started creating content for online platforms such as Teachable, Udemy, SimpliVee, and Bodhami in the form of videos, notes, and examples for easy understanding. If you want to go through them, we have provided their links in the description. You can also access these trainings by visiting our website and online courses tab. Now to end, please like this video if you have found it useful, add your valuable comments, and share this video to your friends and colleagues to improve and refresh their knowledge. If you want to get updates of such a videos from my channel, please do not forget to subscribe it and click on the bell icon and select to get all notifications. And finally, thank you for watching.